All right, well, what is going on, guys? I told you I would make you some YouTube dedicated content, and that is what I'm doing right now. I am in the gym parking lot, and I'm procrastinating. I'm not even gonna lie. I'm telling you the truth. My form of procrastination is making YouTube videos or Instagram stories, but I guess it's better than just, you know, scrolling on my phone, watching TikToks or Facebook or whatever. Like, now the positive habits are fully in effect, and when I'm procrastinating, it's actually something that's beneficial. But yeah, like I'm kind of like scrambling to find like somewhere to take this video because I'm unprepared and I didn't really, you know, think of anywhere to take this or what journey or what valuable information I wanted to throw on top of this, or like I really got nothing. So I'm trying to find a direction in this split second of where I want to take this video. And it's coming to me. No, it's gone. Anyways, this is the pre-workout I have. It's the trifecta. I got the C4 pre-workout explosion with some BCAs, some creatine. So I want to give you like my driving factor and what drives me and what motivates me and what pushes me to the next limit in life. Like every time I'm about to give up or every time life gets a little too difficult or it gets a little too heavy and I want to backtrack and I want to take a couple steps back and just cower away, I always think about, like, if I was 90, looking back at this moment right now, would I be impressed with myself or would I be depressed with myself? Would I be like, damn, I am proud of you looking in the mirror, or would I be like, damn, I fucking hate you looking in the mirror? And that is some heavy shit. And you just gotta, like, fuck. And, like, I don't know. Like, it's so worth it to just continuously keep pushing forward. And yet, obviously, it's going to be harder each and every single time. But that's just because you're leveling up. You're doing more with your life. Your plate is getting fuller and fuller and fuller. And that's how you become successful. It's not going to get easier and easier and easier. But trust me, just because it's hard doesn't mean, you know, it's only hard. Like, it's also satisfying. You know what I mean? You get some satisfaction from it. And that is just something you can't beat. And, you know, you could either just stay in this level for the rest of your life. Like, I could give up right now and I would just, you know, that's it. My life's done. My story's over. The chapter's done. The book's over. The credits rolled down and that's where it all ends. And for me to get back to this place, like, the momentum I've built, getting this fucking jacked, going to the gym 6 days a week, like, me giving this up and putting all the man hours into the content that I've created, like, me giving this up, walking back and try to come back to this place is going to take a lot of fucking work. And it's not even worth it to go back there. Like, I'm already fucking heading in this direction. So let's just keep going through the rain, through the storm. When it's lightning and it's thundering, just keep fucking pushing forward no matter what. It doesn't matter, man. Like, you only got one life. And I know a lot of people say that and it's cheesy, but, like, you know, it never worked for me. When I was younger, people would always say that, and I'd be like, yeah, nobody fucking cares, man. But then I actually got in a car accident that almost took my life, and I was the weakest I ever been in my entire life. I broke my back. Well, I fractured my back, my T10 and my T11. I couldn't even bend over to grab clothes. Like, the doctor was sticking his finger up my ass to see if I was paralyzed. Like, it was some shitty stuff. And that's not even, like, the grand scheme of things. Like, I've been through so much fucking shit. But it's made me into the person I am today. Like, I've had a lot of fucking lows, but that one stood out the most. And now, I don't know, I just got like this zest for life and this drive for life that I can't really explain, and no one can take it away from me. It's just, you know, it's pretty much everything I ever asked for. But the conversation is kind of like dying out now. And I got nothing more to add besides just become more. Be more, make yourself proud, do the things you don't want to do, and put in the work, especially when you don't want to put in the work. And listen, if you're putting in shitty work and you're half-assing it, nobody will care. Your shit will go under the radar. You have to put everything you have into what you want to do. Just pray to God, like, hey, this is what I want, or you know what I mean? Like, just visualize what you want so you have a direction. Because if you have a sailor who has a nice ship, and he's sailing off to wherever the fuck in the middle of the ocean, he has no idea. He's just going to drift away and he's going to be floating at sea and he's going to be lost. But if you have a direction, you just got to straight point to that place. And that's what you need, you know, especially when you start losing belief. You got to have that why. Like, why did I start this in the first place? And why am I pushing towards this direction? And you just got to have that self-belief. And that's where God plays a big part when it comes to just chasing what you want to chase. Because, like, if you don't believe in God, what the fuck are you gonna believe in? You won't believe that you can do anything at all. Like, you'll have, like, you know what I mean? Like, if you're chasing your dreams, it's a lonely path. Like, society is all clustered together doing the same fucking thing. They're all working, they're all partying, they're all doing this, and they all think and talk the same. And, like, if you're chasing your dreams, you're just an outcast, like, weirdo. It's like, why is he doing that? And, like, you're going to have no one to fall on or no one to relate to. And that's when God comes into play. And that's the strongest person to have in your life. And, yeah, but anyways, yeah, it's time to go to the gym. The ambulance is here. Clearly, they know I'm here. They pull up every single time because they're like, damn, this guy goes to fucking town. And he puts it all on the line. So we just got to stand by the... Okay, someone actually got... I don't know what the hell's going on. But anyways, yeah, that's all I have to say. I love you guys. I appreciate you guys. Damn, someone, like, actually probably passed out in this gym. Salute. But anyways, yeah, love you guys. Peace.